Good morning, everybody. What is happening? What is going on? Back at the track. Could potentially be one of our last days of the track. Could get shut down. But as of right now, we had a good chop put session earlier. Had like three or four throws at 47 feet, which is not too shabby for a practice throw, especially for me. Today we just have 3x8 hurdles. Another hurdle day, nice and quick. We're going to kind of tone down what we do. Because nobody really knows what's going on with the coronavirus as far as what meets are going to be held. And I think I should make a completely separate video about it, where I kind of interview my teammates, see what they think of it. There they are, over here somewhere. Yeah, there they are. Interview them, talk to them, see what they think about it, and kind of give you guys the information that we as elite athletes have, that we've gotten from different sources, whether it be USATF or USLC or the governing bodies that kind of control what our season's up to. As you know, NCAA got canceled, and Pac-12 is all canceled, or basically all of NCAA is canceled. So yeah, we're just lucky to be out here training right now. And when we're not allowed to be training out here, I'll let you guys know like the workouts that we're doing so that maybe you're not able to train where you want to train, but that's no reason that you shouldn't be able to get the work in as well. So anyways, we're gonna go hurdle. Hopefully I'll make a dope montage. Probably not as cool as the last one, but hey, here we go.
On the bridge with a Tycon, flow snap, vivid like the Nikon. Been cold with the vibe warm, keep it locked like the vice arm. They got her twisted like the coat arm, heart something froze like the snowstorm. Her tote bag matched the throat charm. She from the land of the sand where they flex so subtle when they drink mint muddle. Left home and her man in the game that he played for the sand of the shade. She parades you to swear in her shades. She like, why you do that? Why he so deceptive? Young, pretty restless. Long as a check is addressed to a residence. She sell pill therapy, she retail on clearance, but she shopping for clarity. Reap what she sold for the dividend. No, what time is the medicine? Copping the wristwatch, Cartier with the bezel on her credit. Demanding hers, web is due. I swear she. She's so sadistic, defensive, pessimistic, reclusive. She too lit, independent. She too quick to dismiss courtship, concerned with malice. She pile up as the bout ends. She throws a talent. She clutch a half full chalice. Sip you from fountains. Check her rap. She chic, maneuver mountains. I. Picture losing sanity to misplaced feelings. Real she kept keeping her makeup bristles. Hotline blink, she sent 1,000 kisses. I just tripped, I sold 1,000,000 tickets. I'm way too focused on this image lately. My mind is racing, looking miles a minute.
Okay, so we're back at the house now, and I wanted to go over one, the fact that we had a great practice. So hurdles, I don't know how well I filmed it, but I filmed it and actually had a pretty good day. Last 2 days I've been hurdling have been on point. Block stars were great, even though I didn't have anybody there. And then over 8 hurdles today was great as well. I feel like I'm moving off the hurdle well, positions into the hurdle well. Hurdle are much better than they have been in the past. And I think it'd be kind of fun to potentially compare what I did last year in USA's to what I'm doing now
just in practice, because I think I'm hurdling considerably faster than I was hurdling at USA's, and I ran like a second to left, like the second best I've ever run. So I think that'd be an interesting comparison. But what I wanted to actually talk about is what us as Phoenix Track Club, because we're one of the lucky groups that gets to continue to train, or is continuing to train as of now. We got kind of lucky, and so I wanted to talk about what we're doing to kind of combat this whole coronavirus thing. And I know it's been talked about a ton, and I think it'd be interesting to get everybody else in the group's opinion, and that could be a completely different video. I know a lot of them watch these videos, so if you want that, comment down below, and maybe they'll read the comments, you never know. But today we had a meeting, outside of having an awesome practice and a good lift, we had a meeting with our coach and everybody else in the group. We kind of laid down some guidelines. So obviously no sharing water bottles. I never gave anybody a high five today. I think I touched one person. I think I accidentally bumped arms with Freddie, but literally everything contact wise has been eliminated outside of sharing equipment. So we still share the same hurdles. We still adjust them. So we're getting our hands dirty. To combat getting our hands dirty and trying not to get sick, there's kind of a generic rule of practice. We're not gonna be touching our faces. So if you see me in the videos wiping something off my face, let me know so that I can stay on top of it. The other thing is we all lift together. So we share the same bar, we share all that stuff. So it's kind of impossible with only two bars to eliminate the kind of spread, or it's really hard not to use, it's really hard not to touch the same stuff that everybody else is touching. So we just make sure that we're washing our hands and we're keeping each other accountable for washing our hands. We kind of have our little separate spots where we usually sit anyways when we're hanging out on the turf, but I know I've had some people reach out to me, not a bunch, but some people reach out to me and they have said like, hey, how are you doing this? Why are you doing this? It's super unsafe for you to be doing this. And we're professional athletes. This is literally our job. We go to the track to do a job. It's not like we're doing this for fun. This is what we're training for. The Olympics are still currently on, and every single person on this team wants to qualify for the Olympics. There's no doubt about that. And if we take a month off, 2 months off, it greatly decreases our chances of qualifying for this next Olympiad. So we're not taking time off from work. We're continuing to work. We're just doing it in the safest manner that we know how to. So we show up to the track, we have limited contact with anybody outside of the group. We make sure we're washing our hands both before we go to the weight room. So anything that we picked up while we're on the track, moving hurdles, on the turf, anything like that, is not gonna be put on the bars. So we all wash our hands before we go into the weight room, and then we all wash our hands after the weight room before we go home or do whatever else we're gonna do. So we're limiting the amount of contact we have with each other and limiting the amount of contact we have with the stuff that is gonna be shared. Obviously no sharing water bottles. We're not drinking out of the water fountain anymore. Kind of just limiting everything. Our coach is not gonna be touching the hurdles anymore. So it's on us to spread the disease within the group. No, but on a serious note, it is a serious thing, and I appreciate everyone's concerns as far as what we're doing training wise, but you have to understand it is actually our job. And so with it being our job, it's on us to do it as safely as possible and in a controlled environment. We have pretty much a private track that we get to use, and we're blessed to get to use, and we limit the amount of contact we actually have with everybody. So as far as the content goes, I'm going to continue to produce it as long as I can. I know it's tough times, and I hope that I can bring a smile to some of you guys' faces on a daily basis, because if you're new to the channel, we post on a daily basis. So if that is you, go check out yesterday's video. It was a pretty great one. I kind of enjoyed it. It was a workout, something new for me that I haven't done with you guys, but I think something I'm going to continue to do in the future, maybe a workout Wednesday or something like that. That also means that tomorrow I'm going to be posting a video, because I post a video every single day. So go check out tomorrow's video sometime before 9 a.m. If you get bored during this time and you don't have anything to do, you've watched all your Netflix shows, I have 361 other videos on this channel. 361. That means there's 361 other videos that you could be watching after this one, from college all the way to professional athletes. It's a wide range. Anyways, I'm gonna go to bed now because it's a little bit later than my bedtime. It is currently, it's already 7:36. Anyways, remember, be nice people, don't hurt yourself, don't hurt others, slow down, don't dance so fast. I'll talk to you guys all tomorrow. Okay, bye.